Welcome back. So we want to look at comparing ratios. Comparing ratios. Comparing ratios. Comparing ratios. In this case, you must be given two or three ratios, and you are supposed to compare it. See which ratio is bigger than the other, which ratio is smaller than the other, and that is how we compare the ratios. Now, once you are supposed to compare ratios, or in order to for you to compare the ratios, then you have to express the ratios in a fraction. Compare each one of the ratios in a fraction. And then from there, you can make them percentages, or you can look at an LCM for all of them and express them in terms of a common denominator. A common denominator. Alternatively, you can make them percentages, and from that, if you make them percentages or a common denominator, you can easily see which one is bigger than the other one. Okay, the resultant fractions or the resultant percentages that you make will make you easily see which of the ratios is bigger than the other, which one of the ratios is smaller than the other. And let us take this example here. Which ratio is greater? Is it 2:3 or 4:5? So we are trying to see which one of the ratios is greater. Suppose we say that our quantity has been adjusted by the ratio 2:3, and then the same quantity has been adjusted 4:3. How do we compare the resultant values? Now, first of all, we need to compare the ratios. We compare the ratios and say this ratio is bigger than this, or this ratio is smaller than this. But for our question, we say which ratio is greater. So we need to get the greater ratio between the two, and the other one to be the smaller one. So first, we have said we make them fractions. We make them fractions. So 2:3. If we make this one as a fraction, then it is going to be 2/3. The other one is 4:5, and we make it as a fraction, it becomes 4/5. Now, from there, we can make them percentages, or we can make them the same, having the same denominator. If they are supposed to have the same denominator, then the common denominator for 3 and 5 is obviously 15. So we can make 2/3 have a denominator of 15, 4/5 have a denominator also of 15. So in this case, to have a denominator of 15, we are going to multiply both numbers by 5. So 2/5, 3/5. That will give us 10/15. The other one, to make it a common denominator, we have to multiply the denominator by 3. So the denominator by 3, the numerator also by 3. That will give us 12/15. So it means these ratios, we have made them as fractions under the same denominator. So 10/15. For the first ratio, 2:3, the other one, 4:5, would be 12/15. And from these two ratios, which one is bigger? The one which has the biggest numerator, of course, is the biggest, obviously. So 12/15 would be larger than 10/15. And 12/15 is made of the ratio 4:5. We can also make these fractions as percentages. So that means you multiply by 100, and 2/3 by 100 will give us 66.7%, and 4/5 multiplied by 100 will give us, let me put it this way, the first ratio, which is 2/3 multiplied by 100, that will give us 66.7%, and the other ratio is 4/5 multiply by 100, that will give us 80%. 80%. Again, expressing them in percentages, we see that the ratio 4:5. This is coming from 4:5. The other one is coming from 2:3. So we can see that the ratio 4:5 gives us 80%, which is greater than 6.7. So in that way, we can now choose the one which is greater, and we see 4:5 is greater than 2:3. So simply we can write it this way. 4:5 is greater than 2:3. The ratio 4:5 is greater than the other ratio 2:3. And that is how we can compare these ratios. Now look at this other example. Arrange the following ratios in increasing order. Arrange the following ratios in increasing order. So that is that means we need to get the smallest followed by the other one until the largest. Now how do we do that? First, arrange them or express all the ratios in terms of a fraction or in terms of fractions, and then from there we make them percentages and calculate, and we can see that 2:3, this is the same as 2:3. The other one, 1:4, this one give us 1/4, a quarter. The other one, 3:7, this one will give us 3/7. So those ratios in terms of fraction, we can make them percentages, multiply by 100. This will give us 66.7%. A quarter multiplied by 100, we want to make it percentage. This one will give us 25%. The other one multiplied by 100 will give us 45.7%. So from those percentages, which one is greater than the other? We can now arrange them from the smallest to the largest. And the smallest is 25 from that. 25 followed by 25 is less than 45.7 is less than 66.7. And from these percentages, which ratios form these percentages? 25 is formed by the ratio 1:4. So that is less than 45 is formed by the ratio 3:7, which is less than the other ratio. 66 is formed from the ratio 2:3. So the ratios can be arranged in increasing order. Increasing order 1:4, followed by 3:7, followed by 2:3. That is very good. That's very good. We can now arrange ratios in terms of increasing or decreasing order. And this is very important because it is a way of comparing how much one gets if the deficient is in terms of a certain ratio, and if the deficient is in terms of another ratio, how much would be the quantities. You can make that comparison by looking at which of the ratios is greater or less by comparing them. And we can look at distribution or distributing a quantity in a given ratio. Distributing a certain quantity by a given ratio. And from this we already say that if you are given a whole quantity and you need to get a quantity of a certain ratio, given a whole quantity and you need to get one quantity of a certain ratio within there, then the most important thing is to first of all remember that the total quantity represents or is directly proportional to the total ratios. The total quantity is directly proportional to the total ratio. And you can express your individual quantities in terms of the ratios, in terms of the fraction of the ratios. Now, for example, if you are given a ratio, a quantity which has a whole quantity and supposed to be divided in the ratio A is to B is to C. Okay, a certain quantity, whole quantity, and this quantity is supposed to be divided in that ratio, then we can say that A will get out of this, because the total of the ratios is A plus B plus C. But we need the ratio, the quantity that A will get, so it will be A out of the total, that is A plus B plus C. B will get B out of the total, A plus B plus C. And C will get out of the total C over A plus B plus C. So we will look at several examples later on how to distribute a quantity to a given or given ratio, to a given ratio, and how much one quantity from the ratios will be if those ratios are given. So thank you very much. We'll look at this later on in our next video.